I not to have you, your bush father?
Mr. President, you know I'm not here for nothing. For me to leave my parish to this place is for a very sensitive reason. Mr. President, you know, Nigerians are worried. Yes, because a lot has been going wrong in the country. But then, nobody gets to hear from you. We hardly even see you on national TV. Whenever there's an issue, a national issue for that matter, you hardly address us. You know, sometimes we get into some problems and we fight our way out of it without hearing from the president. I want to know, what is the problem? Why do you find it difficult to address your people?
Well, I don't want to say what I'm going to say another thing. Because Nigerian media is not helping at the matter. Whenever I come out to address the nation, it will not be as what I said, that I will hear. So I am selecting my words in terms of addressing the nation. So for you to say that I don't normally address the nation, I think you don't read the paper.
So, Mr. President, are you blaming the media?
Yes, of course. The media is supposed to be a way for the people to get an information from me. But what I am seeing for the media is not encouraging.
Okay, now, Mr. President, ever since you assumed office in 2015, till date, there have always been a consistent and constant increase in the price of fuel. A lot of Nigerians cannot cope with that, and it makes life more difficult for them. So, Mr. President, tell us, why have you been unable to handle the petrol sector to regulate these prices so that at least the average Nigerians can afford it?
Well, Nigeria is the only country that the government still pays subsidy for the nation. If you go to Dubai, our neighboring country here in Africa, Ghana and Benin Republic, Nigeria buys the cheapest amount of petroleum. And for us to increase the amount of fuel, we are doing it to reduce accidents on the road.
What? But what do you mean by that, Mr. President?
Because a lot of people drive motor where they don't have money to buy fuel.
Are you normal?
So by increasing the fuel, I think you can economize and the other have to know your speed limit. Thank you.
Mr. President, what is the connection between fuel and accidents? Is it that when people are driving, because you want to reduce accidents, you have to increase the price of fuel?
I think if you want to get more light on that, you should meet my Minister of Information.
That is one of the problems of the country, Mr. President. Your Minister for Information is a big liar. He doesn't tell the country the truth. In fact, I would recommend you change him. He doesn't know how to pass information. He tells us lies all the time. Mr. President, sometimes I even wonder how you got to select the people in your cabinet.
Look at you.
Well, I can't change him because his father was faithful to me.
Child.
And he's also faithful to me.
So you put him there because of his father?
He's tested and trusted. I so much believe in him.
Okay, Mr. President, let's talk about COVID-19. First of all, Mr. President, why don't you use face mask? We have never seen you on face mask. Why?
Well, I can't wear face mask because corona can never catch corona.
What?
So, Mr. President, are you saying you are coronavirus?
You said it yourself.
Jesus!
Okay, so, Mr. President, why is it that the vaccine they brought into our country? I heard from some other nations that the vaccine they brought to Nigeria is one of the cheapest and it's not a very good one. Why is that?
Well, this is a national TV and you're planning to set me up. But in this manner of question, I think you should ask the World Health Organization, not me.
You are the one that purchased it now. I heard it's a very cheap one.
But I was not in the country.
Everything that's happening in this country, you say you are not aware, you are not aware. So how are you leading us if you are not aware of anything? And you are always traveling. Every time you are in London, what are you doing in London? Do you have side chick in London?
Well, Have you been to London before?
Well, no.
You are missing. You have to be there.
Okay, so, Mr. President. Lastly, before I leave, Mr. President, something happened on the 20th of October, 2020.
Chai! What was that?
The Lekki massacre.
There is God.
So, Mr. President, one more time, I'd like to ask you, who gave the order?
The order to do what?
To kill the youth, the peaceful protesters that came out to protest that on that very day.
Were you there?
Well, I was there earlier in the day. But I later left before the shooting started.
You were there?
Yes.
You were alive?
Yes, now I'm alive.
You have to thank God for your life. If truly you were there.
You think so, you're wise?
Mr. President, who gave the order?
Well, I know that you are a man of God, right?
Yes.
And you run the affairs of the Bush Parish.
Yes.
I think you should consider more on your parish than what happened at Lekki. Because I think that even up to now, we don't have any evidence concerning the killings.
Will you keep
and
quiet?
We don't have any evidence concerning the massacre.
Why will you not have evidence? But the youth, they've provided many evidence, Mr. President.
Of what and what?
They've provided videos, everything. And you people are still denying it.
What type of video?
You are denying it.
What video?
The video of the killing now, the shooting. Even drone videos, everything. They have all the evidence. You people are not doing anything about it. And it seems like the youth are forgotten. But we can never forget what happened on
that
day.
Father, the last time I checked, I am not your mate. So, I'm not sure that the Christendom is aware that you are here. Because you come on your own accord and accepted you. So mind your ways. For us, nobody will remember you again.
What do we have?
Mr. President, are you threatening me?
I am telling you this from the bottom of my heart. Well, like what I said before, there is no evidence that anyone was killed at Lekki. If you have the evidence, Father, provide it. You don't have. So please don't ever in your life research an issue to my villa again.
Yeah, thank you very God. Much.